According to co-founder Irvin Lochter, the campaign Rock the Vote was significant at the polls. The conclusion, he says, is based on research from its social media.
Facebook, Twitter, mostly. We saw, like, we have over 20,000 friends on our Facebook page, and we saw that a lot of people would post their picture of their voting finger and said, "I rock the vote," and keep on saying, "I rock the vote, I rock the vote, I was proud to rock the vote." And that's a lot of youth and new voters who are really excited to do that.
Mr. Lochter says the campaign was worth it and it does not stop because the elections are over. He says the pressure is now on for the implementation of youth policies by the new administration.
It doesn't stop with just elections. I mean, there are policies that affect the youth, there are policies that affect the future, and we should always keep the pressure on, whichever government it is, keep the pressure on to see that those policies are changed if they don't suit, you know, the youth.
The Rock the Vote campaign was launched in September 2010 with the aim of, among other things, mobilizing the youth to go out and vote. For the DBS News World, Alex Buske reporting.